What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to another day in my Corvette life. Today's just going to be a real quick video. There's been some breaking news as far as the mid-engine Corvette goes. So I've made a couple of videos about the mid-engine Corvette. If you haven't seen those already, I'll put a link in the description below. Definitely check those out. So today's breaking news is apparently some leaked CAD pictures of the mid-engine car were posted anonymously on CorvetteForum.com, most likely by somebody at GM. Now, whether it was an intentional leak or not, nobody knows. But let's get into it right now. Now, we've all seen the spy pictures of the mid-engine car. Here we see it at the McDonald's drive-through. This picture here, you can see the rear bumper a little bit. It's got square exhaust outlets. And then there was even some leaked images, apparently from the new paint facility in Bowling Green, showing the front and rear bumpers of the mid-engine car. So here is the leaked images of the engine and engine cradle. It appears to be an LT1 or a derivative of the LT1. It also looks to have factory headers instead of cast exhaust manifolds. We can't tell whether or not it is a manual or automatic transmission. There are no turbos shown. And the rear engine subframe is huge, and it looks to be a strange mix of parts and welded tube. The second leaked image appears to be the rear section of the frame of the car. You can see the massive brakes, and finally we can see that this car has coilover shocks. Corvettes historically have used leaf springs in lieu of coilovers to save money and space. It also appears that this car still uses hydroformed frame rails, probably aluminum, similar to the C7 Corvette. So that puts to rest any kind of unibody or carbon fiber monocoque construction that was rumored. GM was also recently granted a patent for a twin-charged, high-compression hybrid electric powertrain. A supercharger, a turbocharger, a compression ratio ranging from 11 to 1 to 16 to 1, and one or more electric motors. Could this potentially be a powertrain for a future Corvette? Only time will tell. These images you see here are the actual images shown on the patent. This is certainly not the powertrain shown in the leaked CAD pictures, but it definitely has potential for high performance. GM has also released some information about their forecast for future engine needs. And these were among the suspected engines for future Corvettes. The code Y1 appears to be for the front engine Corvette platform, which is currently in use today. And Y2, we think, is for the mid-engine platform. Potentially, the front engine C7 and the new mid-engine Corvette could be sold side by side as soon as 2020 or even 2021. As we see here, there is a 6.2-liter 16-valve overhead valve engine for the front-engine Corvette platform, which is probably the current LT1 or something very similar. And then we also see a 6.2-liter 16-valve overhead valve engine for the Y2 platform mid-engine car, which is exactly what we see in the CAD pictures. And then we have a 4.2-liter and a 5.5-liter 32-valve dual overhead cam engine, possibly for the mid-engine platform. Now, dual overhead cam engines have been rumored for future Corvettes for many years now, back since the C4 ZR1. So people have definitely been looking forward to that, and they might just be getting it. So that's gonna do it for today's breaking news. If you did enjoy this video, please give me a big thumbs up. If you're not already subscribed, please hit the subscribe button below. And until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.